I want to tell you a little bit about my story that I heard from Dave Ramsey. The example that he gave is, for organizations to grow and thrive, you need more thoroughbreds and not donkeys. And that got me thinking because, first of all, I highly respect this guy, and he's done phenomenal things. And the example that he gave was so phenomenal because I'm, out there recruiting on a day-to-day basis, building a team, a high-performance team, trying to develop the best in class. And, just the words that he used and using thoroughbred specifically stood out to me because I look at the resource and the team, the best of the ones that I have are all thoroughbreds. And I'm like, wow, without even kind of thinking, I've been, visualizing high performance players and then being able to recruit them and to retain them. So, and the other side of it is sort of donkeys. And he says, you can find them everywhere. They're all over the place. And the fact of the matter is it's true. I go through hundreds and hundreds of resumes to find one that I want to interview, or my team actually goes through hundreds of candidates to be able to just meet one. And so, and what I want to say today is, how can you become a thoroughbred, right? A thoroughbred is a raising animal. It goes on races and wins races, $1 million animal. It's like a celebrity at the end of the day. And what you want to do is you want to be able to perform like a thoroughbred, right? On the other side, you have donkeys. There's sort of, what can you do with a donkey at the end of the day, right? You can only do so much. You're definitely not going to be winning any donkey races, and there ain't one, even if you wanted to race, right? So at the end of the day, what you want to do is develop all of everything around you to be thoroughbred. So when you delegate something, they're able to go and run with it. They're able to solve problems. One of the things that I've come across, so many people I work with, the difference between some of them versus the other is, and one of my teammates were talking about it, it's the ability to solve a problem. If you can solve problems, then you can virtually do anything, right? So if you can look at a problem and say, look, I understand this is a challenge, XYZ issues need to be resolved, and these are the constraints. How do I do X, with these constraints? And doing that in the real world, doesn't matter if there's a marketing problem, an accounting problem, management problem, production problem, it doesn't matter. As long as you can solve these kinds of problems, you become more and more valuable in the professional world, right? So if you think about it, and that's sort of the same thing, you have thoroughbreds who can perform at amazing speed and win races because they're trained for it, right? They're trained to do that, and they eat the best food, they get the best massage, they get the best treatment for a reason, because they're made to do something. So in your world, if you're trying to be a thoroughbred in that organization, you want to be hanging around with more thoroughbreds and not donkeys, right? So there's a good book that I read in the past. It's called Lynchpin. Take a look at that, because at the end of the day, any organization will take you and want you to become an invaluable person in that team, right? So you want to be able to become a linchpin. That's the word. But essentially, the only way that you could do that is you're at the sum of the five people that you hang around with, right? So if you want to be a millionaire, then hang out with millionaires. If you want to be a good coach, then hang around with good coaches, right? If you want to become really good at sport, play with those folks that are really, really, really good at it. And if you want to be really good at marketing, hang out with the best marketers that you can find at the end of the day, so that you can actually attract and become that. So just that concept of becoming a thoroughbred, and I'm going to be using that more in my recruiting, and to really see and putting the test, the case studies and everything in front of folks and having them solve problems real time, knowing that you can identify a thoroughbred from all the donkeys that you come across. And personally, you don't want to be that donkey. You want to become a thoroughbred for the organization, for yourself, for your company, for the team that you're around. In any way, shape, or form, you want to make sure that you can go and win races. You want to make sure that you are taken care of like a thoroughbred, and so you can do the best in class races and win, and not just sort of waste time like a donkey. So I hope this video is useful. If you want to check out the original video by Dave Ramsey, I believe just put thoroughbred into YouTube and you'll find it I think it's been an amazing content for me, and I probably would come across more of these sort of examples. I would love to make more content around it. But for those of you out there, especially the ones that ask me for recruiting help and what should I do about hiring a marketer, you know, we'd like to have an internal marketing person help me with it, or sales support person. And it's not something that you can just go to school and then magically become a marketing expert. I think you need to attract those thoroughbreds that you can give a task to, and they'll run with it as fast as possible, faster than anyone else you've ever seen. And that's the kind of folks that you want to be able to attract to your organization. Then you'll be able to move the needle faster and find the most optimal way to win, rather than just sort of figure out, hey, what should we do for marketing, and not really see a single strategy come out. And then you're not going to be able to win the races. So I hope this has been useful. Thanks a lot for tuning in, and I will see you next time.